Good morning. Welcome to my designer diary. So last week I was saying that my Kickstarter for the Cepheus Deluxe was still kind of running. It had about 48 hours, 36 hours or something still to go. And so I said that next week I would give you more of a breakdown. So obviously the project has ended and it funded successfully. So now Kickstarter is going to take 5% plus card fees off that. So I'm likely to get 2,300 maybe from it, which is that's quite nice. Ridiculously big percentage because I set my goal so low, and a nice healthy lot of backers. It helps in part mainly because it's such a popular game system. Launched January 17th, ended on 28th, so it was 11 days. I actually got that wrong. It was meant to end on about 4 p.m. on the 29th, but I got my time zones wrong, and so it ended at midnight on the 28th. Lesson learned. So I'm in the 14-day waiting window, but I'm also waiting for a second proof because I was just kind of getting everything together. Ready to pre-preparing all of the fulfillment emails, and then I noticed an error in the print proof. So I've had to order a second proof, and DriveThru are being a bit tardy with that at the moment, or Lightning Source really, not DriveThru. So that is is likely to be kind of sort of third week. Late second week of February before I actually do get to fulfill it. So here's my kind of curve. Okay, so nice big first day. That's when all my emails went out. I managed to get the drive-through emails out. So that's a good launch. 23 minutes to funds this time, which is better than I think it was 53 minutes last time. So that's good. And then because I wasn't in a blackout, I actually managed to arrange the second emails and things. So you can see this nice strong end there because the second emails went out. A third of all my funding came via Kickstarter. The bulk of it came through customer referrers. Now I'll just swap this table back to the beginning. Come on. Right, okay, you're being awkward. Let's just try that. Ah, no, there you go. Right, okay, sorry about that. So the customer referrers, DriveThruRPG 1 is the first email sent. I managed to time it so it went out within 20 minutes or so of my actual launch. Meredith sent that for me. Now I got 40% of my funding off that one email. The DriveThru RPG 2, I had that sent out on the late on the Wednesday, and I was ending on the Friday, and it was the kind of 48 hours to go. And I've got 10% of the funding there, but between the two, that's 50% of my funding straight off DriveThru RPG. The other email sources of so email there, that's a Kickstarter email. The last chance to back is the Kickstarter email. I think Stella Gamma sent a email as well. That's emails from people watching the project, and then there's one of the emails I sent, Earl of Fife. That's they mentioned me in their email newsletter, and is it on this page? On the next page, Wormworks. That also mentioned me in their email in their email newsletter. So the vast majority of all of my backers came from email sources. There's virtually nothing there which you'd count social media apart from YouTube, and that was just putting the link in the YouTube of comments. So yeah, that works. I'll be definitely doing that again. So yeah, that's it. 30% of my project followers backed it. Now this is the really interesting bit. So these are the four tiers. The first one is the $1 tier, just to back it with no reward, and everyone gets a backer kit, community fund $1. Now the most common reward is the £4, about $5, for which you get two PDFs, and that's got by far the biggest, 45% of all backers, but provide 20% of the money. The next one, it's you get the PDFs and you get the you can buy the print-on-demand books at cost. So that produced 20% of the money. So that was also 20%. So between them, that's 40% of all the money, but nearly a quarter of the backers. Now, this last tier where I threw in, there's a print-on-demand card deck, there's the previous book, and the print-on-demand versions and the PDFs, so you get far more for your money here. That produces 60% or 61% of all of the money, although only a third of the backers. So although it's I think if you're going to buy P the print-on-demand, then I suppose if you're only paying one lot of delivery, these actually start to look more attractive. I did say in the tier that it was a print-on-demand card deck, and the shipping to Europe's horrible. So that's interesting. That followed a similar profile to my of what was it called? It was the Bare Bones Fantasy. Similar profile. That in fact, the more expensive tier provided most of the funding. So it's certainly something I should aim for in future, although I can't do it with my next one. But yeah, de definitely worth doing a kind of everything in the kitchen sink tier at the top. So I can't show you anything below that because it starts to reveal people's names and things. So that was really interesting. And again, it's going to be about 20 days to fulfill that. But I've also set up Solo Panda Fu, which is Yin Yang Panda solo rules in a zine format. So that is set up. It's all approved, ready to go. Again, it's the same tier. I have no start date there, but I have set the end date because I want to end inside the zine month. And so at the moment, I've got nine followers for there, but I haven't really told many people about it. And this is the pre-launch page. When you've got 10 people following it, it starts to show the count. So I'm at nine. So it's even possible by the time you see this video, I might have got my 10th person. And I'll put this URL in the of the YouTube video comments as well, because I saw, I've got six backers off the YouTube videos last time, so it's worth repeating. So that's it. So I was worried that I wouldn't actually get to do Zine Quest this year. It was actually meant to, I meant to do what, my first one last year, and it just never happened. So I'm starting to get a kind of cycle going. So that I'm really, really pleased with. And my patrons will get the same rewards as my backers. So yeah, they've it's all becoming part of a continuum where the patrons are kind of they're at the front of the queue and they get the same rewards. Then you've got the Kickstarter as a kind of pre-launch pre-order site in the middle, and then long tail sales on DriveThru, Amazon and other storefronts. Okay, so that's it. That's my kind of workflow is still working, which is cool. And yeah, it was just, I mean, that little in between bit where I want to fulfill the first one before I hit the go live on this one. Okay, so that's it. Thank you for watching.